The next topic is risk management. So risk is an uncertain event or condition that if it occurs has either a positive or negative impact or on or more project objectives like scope, schedule, budget, or quality. In project management, risk management is a practice of identifying, evaluating, and preventing or mitigating the risk to a project that have the potential to impact the desired outcome. The project managers are typically responsible for overseeing the risk management process throughout the duration of a given project. So the practices in risk management, like planning for risk, assessing the risk, developing risk response strategies, monitoring risk to determine how risk changes during the project lifecycle. The project risk can be defined by the project management institution as the effect of uncertainty on a project as a whole, or the exposure of stakeholders to the consequences of variations in outcome. So this is by the Association of Project Management. The types of project risks are like financial risk, strategic risk, or performance risk. Financial risk means the monetary factors of the project. Strategic risk, the strategies chosen to complete a project. Performance risk involves the overall project performances. The project risk management can be a hard thing to master, and all the uncertainty while managing can be stressful. According to Project Management Institute, the project risk may be defined as a chance of certain occurrences adversely affecting the project objectives, the degree of exposure to negative events, and their probable consequences. As a result, the project risk is defined by three factors: the risk event or identification, the risk probability, the amount at stake. That means what could be potentially be lost. Identifying, analyzing, and responding to risk factors through the whole project process is defined as the project risk management. Why risk management is important? Because it empowers a business with the necessary tools so that it can adequately identify and deal with the potential risk. Once the risk has been identified, it is then easy to mitigate it. So risk management helps to avoid litigation, the process of taking legal actions, loss of revenue, negative public perception. Management of risk is always vital in making sure a company and leadership understand what the potential problems could be, helping them create solutions for those problems and mitigate their risk. The elements of risks are identifying the risk, assessing the risk, treating, mitigating the risk, monitoring and reporting on the risk. In order to deal with the risk, there are four primary ways to handle risk in the professional world, whatever the industry may be. That includes avoiding the risk, reduce or mitigate the risk, accept the risk, and transfer the risk. The project risk management process. So in project, a risk or risk management is a practice of identifying, evaluating, and preventing or mitigating risk to a project that have the potential to impact the desired outcome. A risk management plan documents the whole process, including identification, evaluation, and risk mitigation. It also includes risk control monitoring, cost-benefit analysis, and financial impacts. Risk identification is the process of documenting any risk that could keep an organization or program from reaching its objective. It's a first step in the risk management process, which is designed to help companies understand and plan for potential risk. And for identifying the risk, the methods used for identification of the risks are like brainstorming, Delphi method, interview, root cause analysis, SWOT analysis, assumption analysis, etc. Performing qualitative risk analysis. The qualitative risk analysis involves identifying threats or opportunities. So opportunities means if the risk is positive, it is opportunity. If the risk is negative, it is threat. How likely they are to happen and the potential impact if they do. The result in qualitative risk analysis, the results are typically shown using a probability or impact ranking matrix. This type of analysis will also categorize risk either by source or effect. Then comes the quantitative risk analysis. It is evidence-based. It assigns numerical values to risk based on quantifiable data such as cost, logistics, completion time, staff sick days, and so on. You will usually perform one after a qualitative risk analysis. It's a way to further assess the highest priority risk. Plan risk responses. Risk response planning is a process of developing options and determining actions to enhance opportunities and reduce threats to the project's objectives. It includes the identification and assignment of individuals or parties to take responsibility for each agreed risk response. The implement risk response process is where you take your response plans and actually do the work to make them happen. The execution of risk response plan is important because you cannot always depend on talking about the potential problem as enough to get it remedied. And finally, monitoring risk. It is the steps of the risk management process where companies must measure the success of their strategies to improve them. Organization must first understand the risk, that is, identify the risk, implementing agreed upon risk response plan, tracking identified risk, identifying and analyzing new risk, and evaluating risk process effectiveness throughout the project. So the organization must first understand the risk, deploy a risk strategy, but also monitor its results to adapt if it is needed. That's all from risk management. Thank you.